Our fifth presenter this afternoon is Prince Singh, whose title is Developing Materials for High Temperature Applications Like Aircraft Engines.
If global aviation industry was a country, it will be the seventh largest polluter in the world. So we, as mechanical engineers, ask ourselves what we can do to reduce the pollution from the aircraft. One thing we can do is to make the engines that are used in these aircraft lighter. Lighter engines consume less fuel and emit less carbon dioxide, and they emit lower pollution. So how do we actually, what are the challenges associated with making these engines? Image on the upper top, upper right hand side of the slide shows you engine that is being tested at around 1000 degrees centigrade. As you can see, the metal is glowing dark, which means the metal is around 1000 degrees centigrade, and most of the metals cannot survive this temperature and they become very soft and unusable. So the question that you ask us, how do these metals become so soft? On the bottom left corner, what you can see here is a schematic of a regular metal. Most regular metals are made up of smaller blocks of metals, which are joined together by something called polymer. Polymers are sort of a glue which joins these blocks together. The polymers are hard at room temperature, but as soon as you start heating the whole material, these boundaries become soft. So what is the current approach that is being taken to solve this problem? And the current approach involves removing the grain boundaries or the boundaries completely, because these boundaries are the problem.
And it makes this material very hard at higher temperatures. But the problem is, although the material is hard at higher temperatures, the parts made by them are still very heavy.
We take a completely opposite approach. What we do is, we make the blocks of metals even smaller, almost 10 nanometers, which is 100,000 times smaller than the human hair. And when we make these blocks of metals this small, we find that the strength of these metals is 5 times stronger than the currently used metals. But there is a problem though. When we make these blocks smaller, what happens is the amount of glue or the boundary between them is also increased. And then you're going to say, Prince, didn't you tell us that the boundary was actually the problem? Well, yes, but that is part of my research. How do we make the boundaries or the glue between these blocks of metal stronger? So what we do is, we add a high temperature metal such as tungsten into these nanocrystalline metals or the small block metals, and this tungsten actually goes into the boundaries and which makes it very hard. So up to this point, by adding tungsten, we have been able to make these nanocrystalline metals or the small block metals strong up to 450 degrees centigrade. Although we haven't been able to reach 1000 degrees centigrade yet, but we are always trying to push the boundaries and reach that limit. Thank you.